ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। जय श्री कृष्ण। प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि कौर भक्तवृंद। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवरधारी, यशोदानंदन ब्रजजनरंजन, यशोदानंदन ब्रजजनरंजन, यमुना तीरवनचारी, यमुना तीरवनचारी, यमुना तीरवनचारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवरधारी, यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तीरावनचारी, यमुना तीरावनचारी, यमुना तीरावनचारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा 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 हरे हरे। जय राधा गोविंद राधा गोविंद राधा गोविंद श्री राधे, जय पंचतत्व जय पंचतत्व जय पंचतत्व जय पंचतत्व, जय प्रभुपदा जय प्रभुपदा जय प्रभुपदा जय प्रभुपदा, हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल नित्य गौर हरि बोल, नित्य गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल, नित्य गौर हरि बोल। एवं विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्रजकाचार्य स्तोत्र सदश्री श्रीमदिश्री भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय। नामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरि गोवर्धन की जय। वृंदावन धाम की जय। यमुना माई की जय। भक्ति देवी की जय। तुलसी देवी की जय। सामवेद भक्तवृंद की जय। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज हरे कृष्ण। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज हरे कृष्ण। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज हरे कृष्ण। All glories to Sri Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। टुडे वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 1 चैप्टर 7 टेक्स्ट 13 एंड 14। The name of the chapter entitled is The Son of Drona Punished. Read the Sanskrit.
Yada mrdhe kaurava srinjayanam vireshvatho viragatim gateshu vrikodaravid kada bhimarsha bhagnorudande dhritarashtraputre bhartul priyam dronir इति स्म पश्यन् कृष्णासुतानां स्वपतां शिरांसि उपाहरद्विप्रियम् एव तस्य जुगुप्सितं कर्म विगर्हयन्ति।
रीड टू मोर टाइम्स।
यदा मृधे कौरवसृञ्जयानां वीरेश्वतो वीरगतिं गतेषु वृकोदराविद्ध गदा विमर्श भग्नोरुदंडे धृतराष्ट्रपुत्रे भर्तुर्प्रियं द्रौणिरिते स्म पश्यन् कृष्णासुतानां स्वपतां शिरांसि उपाहरद्विप्रियं एव तस्य जुगुप्सितं कर्म विगर्हयन्ति। यदा मृधे कौरवसृञ्जयानां वीरेश्वतो वीरगतिं गतेषु वृकोदराविद्धगदा विमर्श भग्नोरुदण्डे धृतराष्ट्रपुत्रे भर्तुर्प्रियं द्रौणिरिति स्म पश्यन् कृष्णासुतानां स्वपतां शिरांसि उपाहरद्विप्रियमेव तस्य जुगुप्सितं कर्म विकर्हयन्ति।
बट वर्ड बाय वर्ड। यदा वेन मृधे इन द बैटल फील्ड कौरव द पार्टी ऑफ धृतराष्ट्र सृजयानाम ऑफ द पार्टी सृंजयानाम ऑफ द पार्टी ऑफ द पांडवास वीरेशु ऑफ द वॉरियर्स अथो दस वीरगतिम द डेस्टिनेशन डिसर्व्ड बाय द वॉरियर्स गतेशु बीइंग ऑब्टेन्ड वृकोदर Bhima, the second Pandava. Avidha, beaten. Gada, by the club. Abhimarsha, lamenting. Bhagma, broken. Urudande, spinal cord. Dhritarashtra Putre, the son of King Dhritarashtra. Bhartur, of the master. Priyam, pleasing. Drauni, the son of Dronacharya. Iti, thus. Sma, shall be. Pashyan, seeing. Krishna, Draupadi. Sutanam of the sons, Swapatam while sleeping, Shiramsi heads, Upaharat delivered as a prize, Vipriyam pleasing, Eva like, Tasya his, Jugupsitam most heinous, Karma act, Vigarhayanti disapproving. Translation. When the respective warriors of both camps, namely the Kauravas and the Pandavas, were killed on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, and the dead warriors obtained their deserved destinations,
And when the son of Dhritarashtra fell down lamenting, his spine broken, being beaten by the club of Bhimasena, the son of Dronacharya, Ashwatthama, beheaded the five sleeping sons of Draupadi and delivered them as a prize to his master, foolishly thinking that he would be pleased. Duryodhana, however, disapproved of the heinous act, and he was not pleased in the least. Purport by His Divine Grace Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Transcendental topics of the activities of Lord Sri Krishna in the Srimad Bhagavatam begin from the end of the battle at Kurukshetra, where the Lord himself spoke about himself in the Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, both the Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam are transcendental topics of Lord Krishna. The Gita is Krishna Katha, or topics of Krishna, because it is spoken by the Lord, and the Bhagavatam is also Krishna Katha because it is spoken about the Lord. Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted everyone to be informed of both Krishna Kathas by his order. Lord Krishna Chaitanya is Krishna himself in the garb of a devotee of Krishna, and therefore the versions of both Lord Krishna and Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu are identical. Lord Chaitanya desired that all who are born in India seriously understand such Krishna Kathas, and then after full realization, preach the transcendental message to everyone in all parts of the world. That will bring about the desired peace and prosperity of the stricken world. Om Jnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamahyam Dadati Swapadantikam. Nama Shrestham Manamapi Shachiputram Atraswarupam Rupam Tasyagrajam Urupurim Mathurim Goshtavati Radhakundam Girivaram Aho Radhika Madhavasham Prapto Yasya Pratita Kripaya Shri Gurum Tam Natosmi. Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhamscha. He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dinabandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute. Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Harit Priye. Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindubhyayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। सो टुडे वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम भगवद्गीता कैंटो 1 चैप्टर 7 टेक्स्ट 13 एंड 14। यदा मृधे कौरवसृंजयानां वीरेश्वतो वीरगतिं गतेषु वृकोदराविद्धगदाभिमर्ष भग्नोरुदंडे धृतराष्ट्रपुत्रे भर्तुप्रियं द्रोणिरिति स्म पश्यन् कृष्णासुतानां सुपतां शिरांसि उपाहरत् विप्रियं एव तस्य जुगुप्सितं कर्म विगर्हयन्ति। सो इन दिस वर्स इट इज बीइंग मेंशन्ड अबाउट हाउ अश्वत्थामा हैज डन सच अ हीनस एक्टिविटी, द मोस्ट अबोमिनेबल एक्टिविटी ऑफ killing the warriors when they were sleeping. And actually, so there are rules and regulations that are there when someone is fighting a war, especially in a Kshatriya war. There are certain rules and regulations, and one of the rules is that after the sun has set down, there is no war. Then after that, actually the enemies would become friends as well after the sunset, and then when the sun rises again the war starts and they become enemies. So in this case, what we are seeing is Ashwatthama has heinously killed the five sons of Pandavas, and this is the Krishna mentions about what the different types of karmas are. Karmanyo hi bodhavyam, bodhavyam cha karmani, vikarmanascha bodhavyam, gahano hi karmana gatim. So Krishna mentions in Bhagavad Gita that one should understand all the three different types of karmas that can be done. So one is karma, karmano hi bodhavyam, bodhavyam cha akarmana. So there is karma, there is akarma, and there is vikarma. So there is three different types. So karma is the normal activity that everyone, the fruitive activities that everyone is engaged in. And this fruitive activity is, as the name suggests, fruitive. So it is done as a matter of getting something back in return, some fruits back in return. So that is fruitive activity. That normal everyone in this material world, under the influence of the modes of material nature, are engaged in these fruitive activities. So this is prakriti kriyamanani gune karmani sarvasha. So ahankar, so this all the activities are being carried on under the influence of the modes of material nature. So yah pashyati tathatmanam akartaram sa pashyati. So Krishna mentions that one who sees that the real us is not doing those activities, the real us is performing only the activities of linking with the Lord. That is the soul is eternally part and parcel of Krishna. So mamai vamsho jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatana mana shashtani indriyani prakriti sthani karshati. So Krishna mentions in Bhagavad Gita that all the living entities are my eternal part and parcels. But when the identification with mind and the five senses takes place, there is this struggle in the material universe. And this karmana is that. So when there is inclination for getting something back in return, that causes all the cycle of birth and death. That is the cause of the cycle of birth and death, because originally the only activity that we are doing is akarma. And why is it akarma? Akarma means no activity.
So originally, all the living entities are doing no activities. What do we mean by no activities? No material activities. Why all the living entities are doing no material activities? Because their only activity is to engage in spiritual connection with the Lord. That is the Nitya Siddha Krishna Prema Sadhya Kaponai Shravanadi Shuddha Chitte Koroya Udaya. This is said in Chaitanya Charitamrita, that this eternal loving service to the Lord is eternally present in all the living entities. So it's irrespective of what kind of living entity it is. It is eternally there. So how does it get revealed? Shravanadi Shuddha Chitte. When one is trying to hear about the Lord with Shuddha Chitte, with cleansed mind, then Koraya Uday, then automatically the revelation takes place. So that is the starting point. Tasmat Bharata Sarvatma Bhagwan Ishiro Hare Shrotavyas Kirtitavyascha Dhyaya Pujyascha Nityada. So this is said in Srimad Bhagavatam that Tasmat Bharata Sarvatma Bhagwan Ishwaro Hari. So Krishna's another name is Hari. And Hari means one who takes away. So the Lord takes away all the material hankerings that is there within the Dhunoti Sarvam Hridi Sannivishta. Swapada Moolam Bhajata Priyasya Tyaktvanna Bhavasya Hari Paresha Vikarma Tattoch Patitam Kathanchit Dhunoti Sarvam Hridi Sannivishta. So this is said in Srimad Bhagavatam that Swapada Moolam Bhajata Priyasya. So when one is constantly trying to engage themselves in the loving devotional service of the Lord by remembering the lotus feet of the Lord, Swapada Moolam Bhajata. So mentally remembering the lotus feet of the Lord. Tyaktvanna Bhavasya Hari Paresha Vikarma Tachot Patitam Kathanchit. So sometimes this Vikarma, so there is this Vikarma. Vikarma is the third type of karma. So the first karma is the fruitive activities. The second karma is no karma at all. Why is it? Because there is no material activity being performed. It's all spiritual. And when there is spiritual activity, there is no, it's not like a normal material activity. It is transcendental to the modes of material nature. And when it is transcendental to the modes, it is like no action. It is inaction. Karmanehi akarmana, akarmanascha karmana ye pashyatiha sa buddhiman manushyeshu sa yukta kritsam akarmakrit. So Krishna actually mentions in Bhagavad Gita that one who sees action in inaction and inaction in action, so that he is a real seer. So there is akarma and then there is vikarma. This vikarma is the one that Ashwatthama has performed in this particular chapter. Is being titled Son of Drona Punished. So Ashwatthama is engaged in Vikarma. Vikarma is something that is heinous activity, ghastardly activity or abominable activity. So but one of the things about Vikarmana is the verse that we discussed just before. Swapada Moolam Bhajata Priyasya Tyaktvanna Bhavasya Hari Paresha Vikarma Tachot Patitam Kathanchit Dhunoti Sarvam Hridi Sannivishta. So what happens is, even if someone has performed Vikarma, if there is sincere repentance on the part of the person who has performed that Vikarma, and one is constantly thinking about the Lord, then Dhunoti Sarvam Hridi Sannivishta. So because the Lord is present in the heart of all the living entities, he cleanses all the impurities, all the vikarma that someone has performed. So in this case, we see in Ashwatthama's case that one of the things about the Lord is, we know this verse, Kaunteya pratijanihi name bhakta pranashyati kshipram bhavati dharmatma shashva chantim nigachyati Kaunteya pratijanihi name bhakta pranashyati. So apichet sudduracharo भजते माम अनन्य भाग साधुरेव समन्तव्य सम्यक् व्यवस्थितो हि सः. सो दिस इज अगेन दिस इज द दिस इज दैट वर्स वेर दुराचार. सो दिस विकर्मा इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड दुराचार और एक्टिविटीज दैट दैट क्रिएट लॉट ऑफ टेंशन इन द वर्ल्ड. सो दैट इज दुराचार. सो अपि चेत् सुदुराचारो भजते माम अनन्य भाग. सो दिस इज अ कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन देर. सो that's why the devotional service to the Lord should never be given up, whether whatever state one finds oneself in. The devotional service to the Lord should never be given up, because that is the only solution for all the it is like a panacea in this universe, the devotional service to the Lord. So this Krishna mentions kshipram bhavati dharmatma शाश्वत शांतिम निगच्छति कौन्तेय प्रतिजानी ही नमे भक्त प्रणश्यति. सो दिस कृष्णा इज आस्किंग अर्जुन टू डिक्लेयर ऑन हिज बिहाफ दैट नो डिवोटी शैल एवर बी वैंक्विश्ड. सो दिस इज द गारंटी दैट कृष्णा इज गिविंग टू एवरीवन. इट इज अ 100% गारंटी दैट माय डिवोटी शैल नेवर बी वैंक्विश्ड. एंड कृष्णा इज आस्किंग अर्जुन टू एक्चुअली डिक्लेयर इट ऑन हिज बिहाफ. To give the promise on his behalf. What is the reason? So Srila Prabhupada mentions this in many of his lectures. What is the reason that Krishna is asking Arjuna to promise on his behalf? Because Krishna sometimes breaks his own promise. This is a prerogative of the Lord, because Lord is not under anyone's control. So natasya karanam karanam cha vidyate natat samasta cha vyatikash cha drishyate parasya shaktir vividaiva shuyate swabhaviki gyana balakriya cha. So the Lord does not have any reason. Na karanam karanam. So the Lord is independent, swarat. So this is mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, the first verse. So janmadya seyata anvayaditaratascha artheshu abhignya swarat. So he is independent, and because the Lord is independent, everything is going under his direction. Maya adhyakshena prakriti suyate sacharacharam hetu nanena kaunteya jagat viparivartate. So under the direction of Krishna, the material nature is manifesting so many different things. The wonderful material nature is going in a exact order. Every day there is sunrise, every day there is sunset, there the seasons change, the order, the exact order, and the order cannot happen by chance. So you, even for something orderly to get created, for example a building, there has to be so much planning done. Just to construct one building, for example, there has to be a foundation. One has to plan first how to make, and then all the ingredients, and then everyone has to work together to make that building. What to speak of this whole material universe, which is going on in such a wonderful fashion. So there is a supreme intelligence behind the material, behind the whole universe, and that is the Lord. The vikarmana. So we were talking about kaunteya pratijanihi name bhakta pranashyati. So the Lord, why is Lord sometimes breaks his own promise? So the example given is when Krishna had to take up the wheel of the chariot and hold it up towards Bhishma Dev. So Krishna had promised that he will not take up any weapon in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. But when Bhishma Dev was really trying to do his best to defeat the Pandavas, then Krishna actually had took up the wheel of the chariot and it tried to defend. So wheel of the chariot is actually not a weapon. So in a way it is not broken, but because he held up something and he was trying to defend the Pandavas, it was in a way it's probably kind of broken promise. So in that way, that Krishna actually asks Arjuna to declare on his behalf. Kaunteya pratijanihi name bhakta pranashyati. This is the guarantee. So we see this in when this continues. So Ashwatthama has done this. Now Ashwatthama will actually try to take the Brahmastra as well. It's like a nuclear weapon. And this nuclear weapon has got such a precision that it can actually go to one particular person and harm that particular person as well. So that's the power of that nuclear weapon, Brahmastra. So we see that Ashwatthama actually tries to do the next heinous, very heinous crime of trying to feticide. So this is he's doing genocide in this, in terms of killing the sons of the Pandavas when they were asleep. And then the next heinous crime that he is going to do is feticide, in terms of trying to kill the living entity, the pure devotee who is there in the womb of Uttara, called Parikshit Maharaj. So this is another heinous crime. And we see there that Krishna himself comes to the rescue of his devotee, Parikshit Maharaj. And we see that even when Parikshit Maharaj's pastimes are coming to an end, Krishna comes again in the form of Srimad Bhagavatam. Krishna Swadhamopagate Dharma Jnana Dibhisaha Kalau Nashta Drisham Mesha Puranarko Dhunodita. So this is said in Srimad Bhagavatam, about Srimad Bhagavatam, that when Krishna went to his abode along with this, Krishna Swadhamopagate Dharma Jnana Dibhisaha. So when Krishna is going, the Dharma and Jnana are going with him. This is the thing, because Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna Yatra Partho Dhanurdhara Tatra Shrir Vijayur Bhutir Dhruva Nitir Matir Mama. So this is this is the last verse in the Bhagavad Gita, where Sanjaya says that Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna. So Krishna is the Lord of all the yogis. So there's Yoginam Api Sarvesham Madgate Nantaratmana Shraddhavan Bhajate Yumam Same Yukta Tamukta. So among all the yogis, Krishna says that Yoginam Api Sarvesham Madgatein Antaratmana. So one who is always trying to remember me within himself, within the core of his being, one who is always trying to remember the Lord, Shraddhavan Bhajate Yoma. So one who is rendering loving devotional service with a lot of faith, Same Yukta Tamomata. So that person is the topmost yogi. So Krishna, and among all the types of yogis, Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna. So Krishna is the Lord of all types of yogis. So there could be a karma yogi, there could be a jnana yogi, there could be a bhakti yogi. So bhakta yoga. So bhakti is na sadhyati mam yogo na sankhya dharma uddhava na swadhyaya tapasyago yato bhaktir mamorjita. So this is Krishna says to Uddhava in the Uddhava Gita part of Srimad Bhagavatam that I cannot be attained na sadhyati mam yogo, through yoga. So what is this yoga? This karma yoga, jnana yoga. Na sankhya, nor through the philosophy, sankhya philosophy. The sankhya philosophy is the understanding of the 24 material elements and the 25th element, which is the eternal soul. Na sankhya, na dharma uddhava, and neither through even religion. Na swadhyaya tapasyago. Then Krishna is saying that not through self-study, swadhyaya, na tapas, not even austerity, not even renunciation. So all this austerity, renunciation, all that has value only when it is done in conjunction with the Lord. If it is done without the relationship with the Lord, then it has no meaning. Shrama eva hi kevalam. Dharma swanushtita pumsam vishvakshena kathasuya notpadiye dratim yadi shrama eva hi kevalam. So this is said in Srimad Bhagavatam that even though one may be performing a lot of religious activities like all the austerities and all the types of renunciation and everything very nicely, swanushtita pumsa, but there is vishvakshena kathasuya notpadiye dratim yadi. So vishvakshena is another name for the Lord, for Krishna. So one who does not develop the attachment to hearing about the Lord, one who is not attracted to hearing about the Lord, विश्वक्षीण नोत्पादयत रतिम रतिम यदि रति इज दैट अटैचमेंट द अटैचमेंट टू नोत्पादयत रतिम यदि विश्वक्षीण कथासु सो दिस इज द सो श्रील प्रभुपाद मेंशंस इन द पर्पोर्ट इन दिस अबाउट कृष्ण कथा सो दैट इज द इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग दैट one has to develop attachment for hearing about the Lord. Whatever be the, it doesn't matter where one is situated. So this is mentioned, sthane sthita shrutigata tanuvan manobhir ye prayase ajita jitopi asitai strilokyam jnani prayase udapasya namanta eva jivanti sanmukharitam bhavadiya vartam sthane sthita shrutigata tanuvan manobhir ये प्रयासे अजीत जीतोपि असिता स्त्रीलोक्यम सो श्रील प्रभुपाद कोट्स दिस वर्ड्स इन मेनी ऑफ हिज लेक्चर्स इट इज सेड दैट दिस इज दैट द लॉर्ड कैन नॉट बी नोन थ्रू द नॉलेज सो अ पर्सन कैन रीड ऑल द वेदास ऑल द उपनिषद्स एवरीथिंग एल्स थ्रू द स्ट्रीम ऑफ नॉलेज बट अनलेस द डिवोशन इज कल्टिवेटेड इन द हार्ट द नॉलेज cannot help in attaining the Lord. Knowledge is only the means of understanding that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. If that is understood, then the goal of knowledge is over. Nothing else needs to be gained from the knowledge. Once that is understood, then that is the end of knowledge. Vedaishya sarvair ahameva vedyam. So what is the goal of all the Vedas? To know that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So this... So this we were saying jnane prayase udapasya namanta eva so this is said that we should not try to understand the Lord through knowledge but namanta eva so just if we can become humble as humble as we can knowing that and this is there is no difficulty in being humble because we know that nothing is totally under our control. There are things that keep changing. Even the current unprecedented circumstances that we are in very clearly shows that through technology and through different other things, we try to control so many things, but then janma mrityu jara vyadhi dukkha dosha anudarshana. So this is... Indriyarteshu vairagyam anahankaram evacha janma mrityu jara vyadhi dukkha doshanu darshanam so this is the quality of a transcendentalist is not attracted towards the sense objects indriyarteshu vairagyam anahankaram evacha so this is namanta eva namanta being humble that is the starting point jnane prayase udapasya namanta eva jivanti sanmukharitam bhavadiya vartam So what is said there is jivanti sanmukharitam bhavadiya vartam. So what is needed is sthane sthita shrutigata tanuvan manobhir. But there is no necessity. For example, in the battlefield of Kurukshetra also we see that Arjuna is fighting in the battle. He is not, is so Arjuna actually wanted to renounce. He wanted to go to the forest and meditate on the Lord. And the Lord says that you fight this battle. That is my... but the Lord actually says that yathe chesi tatha kuru so Krishna actually says to Arjuna that do whatever you like so this is the greatness of the Lord that even though he is a controller of everything and everyone he does not impose himself on anyone so this is the because love cannot be forced on anyone love has to come automatically from the heart it is a natural emotion and when it is directed to the Supreme Personality of Godhead it helps one attain the transcendental state so love is a natural emotion which is there in all the living entities it spans across all the living entities we can see that how the cow is taking care of the calf We see that if we want to get milk from the calf has to be first given the milk. And then the cow gives the milk profusely. Why is that? Because there is a natural love for the mother and child love. It is there in all the living entities, all different types of love that is there. So and the topmost love is the love for the Supreme Lord, which is there eternally in the hearts of all the living entities. So sthane sthita shruti katha tanuvan manogar. So what is mentioned in that verse is that there is no need to, of course, when one reaches that state of highest loving devotional service, one automatically gives up everything, because the state is such high that nothing else gives any satisfaction. So one automatically gives up all the vishaya vinivartante niraharasya dehina rasavarjam rasopyasya param drishtva nivartate. So when one gets that higher state to such an extent that everything else becomes insignificant, then one naturally gives up. That is a higher state. But here in this verse, it is said that sthane sthita shruti gata tanuvan manogar. So initial stage is that one remains at wherever, whatever place one is in, but shruti gata, when one keeps hearing about the Lord, whatever time is available, trying to hear about the tanuvan manogar. So through the body, through the speech, and through the mind. So engaging, trying to engage everything in the service of the Lord. Sthane sthita shruti gata tanuvan manubhir ye prayase ajita jitopi asita is trilokyam. So Krishna is actually ajita. He cannot be conquered by anyone. This is because, as we mentioned in the beginning, swarat. So Krishna is independent. Everyone is dependent on the Lord, but the Lord himself is independent. So therefore he is unconquerable. No one can conquer Krishna, except that when one has the love for the Lord, then he becomes ajita jitopi asi. Then he becomes conquered. Asita is trilokyam. So this is the kind of wonderful thing about Krishna Katha, that when one is engrossed in this discussion about the Lord, then one automatically will forget about everything else. So this is there is this verse where it is said that yatre dyante katha mrishta trishnaya prashamo yata nirvaira yatra bhuteshu nodvego yatra kashchana. So wherever this discussions of about the Lord is going on, yatre dyante katha mrishta trishnaya prashamo yata. So when these discussions about the Lord are going on, one automatically is free from all types of hankerings. All the hankerings are, or material hankerings are automatically going off. Nirvaira yatra bhuteshu, and then there is no enmity between anyone when these discussions are going on. Nodvego yatra kashchana, there is no intensity of doing any material hankering and lamentation. So this is Brahma bhuta prasannatma na shochati na kankshati samas sarvesha bhuteshu mad bhaktim labhate param. So this mam chayo avyabhicharena bhakti yogena sevate sa gunan samatite tan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. So Krishna mentions that one who is trying to be involved in this avyabhicharini bhakti, that is this constantly trying to remember the Lord, bhakti yogena sevate, so rendering service to the Lord, sa gunan samatite tan. So Krishna himself ensures that such a person goes above the modes of material nature, gunan samati detan, and then reaches the brahma bhuyaya kalpate. So then when one is in brahma bhuta stage, then na shochati na kankshati, then there is no hankering and lamentation, and everyone sees as part and parcel of the Lord. Whatever one is seeing, one sees that yomam pashyati sarvatra sarvam cha mayi pashyati tasyaham na pranashyami sacha me na pranashyati. So Krishna mentions in Bhagavad Gita that one who sees me everywhere and everything in me, I am never lost to him and he is never lost to me. So this is the that so when one is trying to be in that state of mind, then the effects of Krishna Katha are fructifying when one can be in that state of mind. So when we said that dharma swanishtita pumsam, so this notpadiya dratim yadi dharma swanishtita pumsam vishvakshena katha suya notpadiya dratim yadi shrama eva hi kevalam. So if one is not getting attached to hearing about the Lord, then all the religious activities and all the activities that one is performing is just a hard labor. So this is what Srimad Bhagavatam is saying. Srila Prabhupada mentions in the purport about the Gita is Krishna Katha or topics of Krishna because it is spoken by the Lord, and the Bhagavatam is Krishna Katha because it is spoken about the Lord. Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted everyone to be informed of both Krishna Kathas by his order. So this is Srimad Bhagavatam Amalam Puranam. So this is mentioned in this Srimad Bhagavatam is purely transcendental. And since Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is mentioned here, we kind of try and understand Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikriti Ahladini Shakti Rasmat. Ekatmana api bhuvipura deha bhedam gatavtav chaitanyakhyam prakatam madhuna tadvayam chaikyam aktam radha bhava dviti suvalitam naumi krishna swarupa. So this is a very beautiful verse that describes about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that he is Radha Krishna pranaya vikriti ahladini shakti rasmat. So this, the activities of Radharani and Krishna come under the Hladini Shakti, the bliss potency of the Lord. And they are one. Ekatmanav api bhuvipura deha bhedam gatavato. So Radha Krishna are one in the sense that because of the love that they have for each other, they are one, but they have taken two different forms. Now Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come, Chaitanya Akhyam Prakatam Madhuna. So he has come now, Tadvayam Chaikyam Aptam. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come now to make them one again. Tadvayam Radha Bhava Dviti Suvalitam Naomi Krishna Swarupam. So he has got the Bhava and Dviti. So he has got the emotions and the complexion of Srimati Radharani, but he is Krishna himself, who has come in the form of his topmost devotee to experience Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima Kidrisha Vanayaiva Sokhyam Chasya Madhanubhata Kidrisho Veti Lobhat Tad Bhava Samajani Sachigarbha Sindho Hari Hindu. So this is mentioned that Sri Radha Pranaya Mahima Kidrisho Vanayaiva. So this Sokhyam Chasya Madhanubhata. So this, what kind of feelings Srimati Radharani is feeling about me? So to experience that, Krishna himself came in the form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So this is the gradation in terms of, but then even though this gradation is there, like Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, but then the Chaitanya Charitamrita's flavor is there in Srimad Bhagavad Gita also. Like when we hear this verse, Machitta Madgat Prana, Bodhayanta Parasparam, Kathayantascha Mamnityam Tushyanti Charamanti Cha. So when we hear that verse, that is like Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu describing Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that Mat Chitta Madgat Prana. So the whole mind and the whole life is absorbed in me, in Krishna. Bodhayanta Parasparam. And what did Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always used to do? Talk about Krishna to everyone. Yare Dekho Tare Kaho Krishna Upadesh Amar Agnya Guru Haya Tare E Desh. So this is mentioned by his order. So this is what so Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted everyone to be informed of both Krishna Kathas by his order. So this is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said. Yare Dekho Tare Kaho Krishna Upadesh Amar Agnya Guru Haya Taro E Desh. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying that by my order you become guru and speak to everyone about Krishna. Amar Agnya Guru Aya. And then Lord Krishna Chaitanya is Krishna himself in the garb of a devotee of Krishna. And therefore, the versions of both Lord Krishna and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu are identical. Lord Chaitanya desired that all who are born in India seriously understand such Krishna Kathas and then after full realization, preach the transcendental message to everyone in all parts of the world. So this is Bharat Bhumite Manushya Janma Haila Yar Janma Sarthak Kari Kar Paropkar. So this is again in Chaitanya Charitamrita. So it is said because, so if you look at this from the perspective of the ancient times, the Bharat was the whole planet. So in that respect, this is valid for all the planet, the whole planet. It's not valid just for the tract of Bharat that is currently there. But then this is also right in the sense that because the people who are born in that tract of land have a natural kind of affinity towards Krishna. So there is more, there potentially has to be a more chance of them picking this up quickly and helping others to understand this. But then there is a kind of ironic angle to this as well, in terms of that there is the grass on the other side looks greener. So this is a kind of analogy that is given, that because everything is so accessible in terms of Krishna consciousness within the Bharat Bhumi, that one doesn't appreciate the transcend, the greatness of what one has. So that is the kind of ironic part to it, that that unfortunately is not helping the cause of propagation of the Krishna consciousness movement. Bharat Bhumite Manushya Janma Hailaya, and that is the most important word there, Manushya Janma, because it's only in the human form of life that one is able to engage in these activities of Krishna Katha. Even though we see in exceptional cases that some animals also are inclined to hearing. The best case is when we hear about Bharat Maharaj, that he become attached to the deer and he becomes a deer in next life, but he still does not forget that he was at an advanced stage of bhava or the loving devotional sentiments for the Lord, and he continues to practice even in the form of deer, continues to hear about the Lord and continues to progress in the spiritual life. So Manushya, but then Manushya Janma is the Durlabham Manusham Janmam Tadapi Adruvam Arthadam Kaumaram Macharet Pragnya Dharman Bhagavatam Iha. So this is said by Prahlad Maharaj, that therefore this involvement in Dharman Bhagavata, Bhagavata Dharma, this discussion about the Lord should take place from childhood itself. Because Durlabham Manusham Janma, because this human form of life is very rarely attained. And even though it is attained, Tadapi Adruvam, it is temporary as well. And Arthadam, it is a great treasure that we have, the human form of life. Bharat Bhumite Manushya Janma Ailayar Janma Sarthak Kari Kar Paropkar. That will bring about the desired peace and prosperity of the stricken world. This is Srila Prabhupada also mentions many times in about United Nations, and even though it is being called as United Nations, but everyone is having their own flag and everyone is trying to protect their own interest. But if Krishna is kept at the center, like how Srila Prabhupada established International Society for Krishna Consciousness, so that Krishna, the consciousness of Krishna, is at the center. And when Krishna is at the center, then this Sarva Yonishu Kaunteya Murteya Sambhavantiya Tasam Brahma Mahadyonir Aham Bija Pradapita. So then if everyone goes with the understanding that there is one Supreme Father and everyone else, all the living entities are Sarva Yonishu Kaunteya. So all the living entities are the children of that Supreme Father. Then that will be the real United Nations. That is the but then it in the material world, it is a kind of utopia as well. It's like a utopian society in the material world, because the material world is, by the nature of the material world itself, it is in the three modes of material nature. So Tribhir Gunamayir Bhavir, Ebi Sarvamidam Jagat, Mohitam Nabhi Janati, Mamebhya Paramavyayam. Krishna mentions that the whole universe is under the influence of the three modes of material nature, goodness, passion, and ignorance. And because of that, one does not know the Lord. Mohitam Nabhi Janati. One becomes attached to these three modes of material nature, Mohitam, and then enamored. One becomes enamored by it. And then because of that, one does not know that the Lord is there everywhere. अंडांतरस्तम परमाणु चयांतरस्तम गोविंद मादिपुरुषम तमाम भजामि एकोपि असौ रचयितम जगदंड कोटि यत् शक्तिरस्ति जगदंड चया यदंत अंडांतरस्थम परमाणु चयांतरस्तम गोविंद मादिपुरुषम तमाम भजामि देयर इज सो सृष्टि स्थिति सो द मटेरियल नेचर इज डूइंग सृष्टि स्थिति प्रलय साधन शक्ति रेखा छाएव यस्य भुवनानि बिभर्ति दुर्गा इच्छानुरूपम अपि च चेष्टते सा गोविंदमादि पुरुषं तमाम भजामि सो दिस इट्स मायाध्यक्षेण प्रकृति स्यूयते सचराचरम दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड इज फंक्शनिंग अंडर द डायरेक्शन सुपरिंटेंडेंस ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड अंडर द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड एंड दैट्स व्हाई देयर इज सृष्टि स्थिति प्रलय साधन शक्ति रेखा देयर इज दिस क्रिएशन दिस मेंटेनेंस एंड द डिसोल्यूशन ऑफ द यूनिवर्स सो दिट्स it's all taking place, everything is going on in order, and this order is by the under the superintendence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Shri Krishna. This is so in this verse, I think the main points that we can take out from this verse is the first point is about the karma, akarma, and vikarma. So that is the first point, that the activities are normal fruitive activities, and the activities that are done directly towards directed towards the Supreme Lord, that becomes inactivity, because in material terms it is inaction. When someone is doing pure transcendental activity, then there is no yajnyartha karma anyatra lokoyam karma bandhana tadartham karma kaunteya mukta sangha samachara. So mukta sangho naham vadi dhrityutsaha samanvita siddhya siddhyo samobhutva karta satvika uchyate. So this mukta sangha, so this free from attachment, when one is in that state, then yajnyartha karmana, then the activities are being performed as an offering towards the yajna purusha, who is Lord Vishnu himself. And so that is akarma. And then vikarma is what we have discussed here about Ashwatthama. So Ashwatthama has done vikarma here, that is the heinous and ghastly activity. And that is what somehow or the other one has to avoid doing that. But unfortunately, if someone does that, even then, there is this. Krishna says that if someone is trying to remember my lotus feet, swapada moolam bhajata priyasya, with lots of love and devotion, tyakta anya bhavasya hari paresha vikarma tatchot paditam katanchit dunoti sarvam hridi sannivishti. So because the Lord is present in the heart of all the living entities, he cleanses that vikarma as well. So this is the greatness of the Lord. That so we can see that Krishna actually cursed Ashwatthama, that he'll be in the suffering form and he will not die. So Ashwatthama is one of the Chiranjeevis as well. There is Hanuman, there are other Chiranjeevis, seven Chiranjeevis. So Ashwatthama is a Chiranjeevi, but he is a Chiranjeevi in a suffering way, because of the ghastly activities that he had committed against the Lord's pure devotees, so Pandavas. So this is what the Lord can never, he can never tolerate anything, any kind of atrocities committed to his devotees. He can never tolerate that. Tanaham dushita kruran samsarishu naradhaman kshipami ajasram ashuban asurishva eva yonishu. So this is so one who is dvishata and krura, one who is envious and one who is cruel, so then it becomes very difficult for them to get out of that cycle, unless one comes in contact with a great devotee of the Lord. For example, if we take the example of Narada Muni and Valmiki, then Ratnakar, Robert. So unless those kind of incidents happen where a devotee gives the costless mercy, it is very difficult for a person to come out of the cycle of Vikarmana. So this is what I can understand from this verse. And this Mahi Yasham Nishkinchana Naisham Matistava Urikramangrim Sparshati Yad Anatha Pagamo Yadartha Mahi Yasham Pada Rajobishekam Nishkinchananam Navranita Yavat. So this is sent by Prahlad Maharaj that unless one is in the one takes the dust of the lotus feet of the pure devotee and takes bath in that. So this is even in the mental sense, if one can do that, then one can understand the greatness of the Lord. And then in such a state of mind, even one can come out of the most heinous activity that was described in this verse of Ashwatthama. Even one can come out of that also by the mercy of the Lord and his pure devotees. So thank you very much for listening. If there is any comments or questions, we can take. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Love for Hare Krishna Karuneshwari Mataji, thank you very much. You have asked something here. Love for Krishna or Bhakti is already within the heart as an intrinsic part of us, and yet Bhakti Devi is also separate personality. How is this to be understood? Thank you very much, Mataji, for this question. I think in the devotional realm, we have a personality associated with everything. For example, even if we take rain, the rain comes, but then we have a personality called Indradeva associated with rain. We have sun is gloriously coming in Ireland for the last few days, and it is a welcome change for everyone. We have Surya Deva as well. So in the devotional world, it is based on personalities. The devotional, because devotion is based on loving reciprocation between the Lord and the devotees and between the devotees. So, and the personality is a very important part in that. And that's what distinguishes the Bhakti Marga with Jnana Marga. The Jnana Marga is concentrating on this oneness. So everything is this. It basically reaches the Brahmabhuta stage, and then it can't go above the Brahmabhuta stage. It just reaches Aham Brahmasmi. So this Aham Brahmasmi is a Mahavakya, which actually gives that understanding that everything is one, in the sense of spirituality, in the sense of spirit. But then the Krishna actually mentions Natva Evaham Jatunasham Natvam Neme Janadipa. So Krishna mentions to Arjuna that there was never a time when these kings were not existing, never a time in future when they will not exist, and in the present we are already different. So this is the foundation of the Bhakti philosophy, and therefore we have the Bhakti Devi as well. So Bhakti Devi is guiding us. She's giving that. So Samvit Sandini and Kladini Shakti. Providing that transcendental. So Nama Naham Prakasha Sarvasya Yoga Maya Samahurta. So Krishna says that I am not visible to everyone. I am protected by the Yoga Maya. So this Bhakti Devi is giving that that Yoga Maya potency, creating the Yoga Maya potency in which the devotees can enjoy the transcendental reciprocal relationship with the Lord, and and between the devotees themselves. So, and Bhakti Devi is creating that environment where this can be done even while being in the material world. So that is the greatness, I think, of the devotional philosophy, that we have a person associated with each and every each and every department, basically, if we want to call it that way. So there's even we have, like, when we say death also has got a personified Yamraj. So we see that in Ajamil's incident in Srimad Bhagavatam, where Yamraj and Yamadutas are coming to get him because he performed Vikarma. We can get back to the Vikarma again here. But Ajamil's Vikarma was not as heinous as Ashwatthama's Vikarma, which is mentioned here. So yes, Mataji, so I think that would be the kind of discussion that we have here, that that bhakti is intrinsically part of each and every living entity, and the Bhakti Devi is helping everyone to inculcate that bhakti and be in that transcendental realm above the three modes of material nature. So I hope that answers, Mataji. Thank you very much for your comment and question. Okay, if there's no other comments or questions, I would like to thank you all very much for allowing me to do this service. Vancha kalpa tarubhyascha kripa sindubhya evacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Kaur Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. All glories to assembly audience, Hare Krishna. Okay, let's see comment as well, one more comment. His Holiness Giriraj Swami Maharaj tells that one time at the GBC meeting, the devotees are trying to establish the function of the GBC. His Holiness Gaura Govinda Swami Maharaj was there and said the function is to give Krishna. Thank you, Prabhu. Oh, thank you very much, Prabhu. I am known to give Krishna, Prabhu. It's devotees like yourself that give Krishna. And then I get a little bit of that from you. Thank you very much, Prabhu. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.